Hi all, today we can discuss about diffraction. What is diffraction? Diffraction is the bending of waves around tiny obstacles or small aperture. In your 12th standard, you have studied the basics of diffraction of light. It is the deviation from the rectilinear path of light, that is the straight line movement of light. Is the diffraction only possible in light waves? Diffraction is the common characteristics of all kind of waves. It is our common experience that we can hear the sound of a person who is standing on the other side of the wall, even though we cannot see that person. Why? Because the sound waves can bend so easily there, but the light cannot. So one of the main conditions for the diffraction to occur is that the size of the obstacle must be comparable with the wavelength of waves there. The wavelength of light is very small, so the light waves cannot bend around the obstacle. But the wavelength of sound is more, so sound waves can bend easily. So in order to produce the diffraction of light, we have to reduce the size of the obstacle. That is why the diffraction of light is not easily observable in our daily life. But diffraction of sound waves occurs easily. One of the easy way to observe the diffraction of light is that hold your hand before a source of light. Then you observe the light through the gap between your two fingers. Then we can see some dark bands in the gap parallel to these fingers. These dark bands are produced due to the diffraction of light. The diffraction of light was explained based on the wave theory of light. So while discussing the diffraction, we are using Huygens principle, we are using the term wavefront, secondary wavelets, etc. In the laboratory to study the diffraction, we require a source of light, a screen and a small obstacle or aperture or a narrow slit. The diffraction is divided into two categories. One is Fresnel diffraction, another one is Fraunhofer diffraction. In Fresnel diffraction, this source of light and the screen both are at a finite distance from the obstacle or aperture. But in Fraunhofer diffraction, both the source of light and the screen are at an infinite distance from the obstacle or aperture. So in Fresnel diffraction, the distance between source of light and slit is finite, and also the distance between screen and the slit is finite. But in Fraunhofer diffraction, both these distances are infinite. In Fresnel diffraction, lenses are not used. But in Fraunhofer diffraction, two convex lenses are used. Why lenses are required in Fraunhofer diffraction? Here the source of light and the screen are at infinite distance. So practically it is not possible to make the screen and the source of light are at infinity. So we are using two convex lenses while studying the Fraunhofer diffraction. One convex lens we are using in front of the slit in order to make the light waves parallel before entering into the slit. One convex lens we are used between the slit and the screen in order to focus the diffracted light beams into the screen. But in Fresnel diffraction, lenses are not used to make the rays parallel or convergent because the source of light and screen are at a finite distance. So we are not using lenses in Fresnel diffraction. In Fresnel diffraction, the wavefront incident on the aperture is either cylindrical or spherical. But in Fraunhofer diffraction, the wavefront incident is plane. Because in Fraunhofer diffraction, the source is at infinity. So if the source is at infinity, the wavefront produced is plane wavefront. So in Fraunhofer diffraction, the wavefront incident on the aperture or the obstacle is plane wavefront. But in the case of Fresnel diffraction, these wavefront considered are spherical or cylindrical wavefront. In Fraunhofer diffraction, to make that a plane wavefront, we are keeping the convex lens in front of the slit. So here we are using a point source of light, but when the light enters the convex lens, it produces the plane wavefront, and the plane wavefront is incident on the obstacle or aperture or slit, and the refracted beam is focused on the screen. In Fresnel diffraction, the phases of the secondary wavelets is not the same at all points in the plane of this aperture. Why? because before entering into the slit, these light waves traveled different distances. So there is a path difference between these waves and it will produce a phase difference. That's why these secondary wavelets produced from the plane of the slits is having different phases. But in the case of Fraunhofer diffraction, using the convex lenses, we made a plane wavefront and these waves are traveling equal distances. Therefore, there will be no path difference when the ray enters the plane of the slit. Therefore, the phases of the secondary wavelets is same at all points in the plane of the aperture or the slits we used. So, if we study this Fresnel diffraction, Fraunhofer diffraction, the mathematical analysis is complicated in Fresnel diffraction, whereas the mathematical analysis is easy in Fraunhofer diffraction because the parallel rays are entering into the slits. So, in the next video, we can see Fraunhofer diffraction at a single slit.